Kindness can be contagious, and Nicole Phillips is proof.
Very excited to have her. She's got her second book coming out. She's got a speech coming up tonight at Hope, and it's always great to have Nicole Phillips in studio. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thank you for having me.
So nice to have you back.
Yeah, it's really, really fun to come back to Fargo. We lived here for 10 years, and then 4 years moved to Ohio 4 years ago. And so coming back is like a, it feels like a family reunion, sort of.
I feel like you never left, and you're following your articles and following you on Facebook, and even now with your second book, you just have a great energy about you yourself. So
thanks.
I love it. Can you tell us a little bit about your second book and what inspired you to do this?
Sure. Well, the second book was actually inspired by the first book, because the first book was a compilation of stories that I had written for the Fargo Forum. And so it was 100 stories, and I thought, you know, if people could read one every day instead of once a week, then maybe it would retrain their brain pathways, because science tells us that that's possible. And so after I wrote the first one and found that people were saying, gosh, I want more stories, and I said, okay, like, let's do it again. if people want to read them, that's great.
How about, you know, not bringing us down, but it seems like we always need a little good news and a little more kindness in our life, especially when people are stressed and you're hearing negative news.
Yep.
Do you think the timing of what you're doing is just perfect?
Yeah, and actually over the last, 7 years that I've been speaking and talking and writing about kindness, I've noticed a trend really take place. And there are all of these people who are coming to the forefront with research about kindness and these random acts of kindness movements and things like that. So kindness is really, is happening. It is really the it subject. But we can feel often like the negativity, mm-hmm. the politics, the violence is really what's running our world. And so it's really a matter of perspective. So this book to me is kind of a vessel to be able to say to people, okay, we do have the choice of letting our minds stick with the hurry and the worry and the jury of all the things that we surround ourselves with, the negativity. Or we can choose to surround our, you know, Instagram feeds with positivity and good stories on Facebook, and read books that really can lift us up, because it does make a difference to the science behind your brain.
So if you would, tell people where people can get the book, but also you're speaking tonight and that's open to the public, right?
Yeah, absolutely. So the book, I'm going to have a couple of book signings. So we've got Red River Coffee, and we have
the NDSU bookstore.
The NDS bookstore, yeah, Red River Coffee and Eco Chic. So those are three places that you can buy the book. And then tonight, I'm going to be speaking at Hope Lutheran at the South Campus at 7 p.m. And I'll sign books afterwards there, too.
And what are you talking about? It's just, hey, here's a way to be like this, just beaming kindness all day long? Or what's the speech about?
The speech is really about making the choice to decide that you're going to be intentionally kind. And this doesn't mean I'm going to give away, you know, $10,000 or da-da-da-da-da, whatever. It's that snap point in your day when the person cuts you off in traffic and you see red immediately. How do you get to the point? Oh, Chris knows he sees red.
You're wearing it.
Well, yeah, there you go. How do you get to the point where you're not seeing red and getting angry right away? How do we train our brains to do that? So that's what I'm gonna be talking about.
I like that. Not just an escape, also a step forward to be intentionally kind.
Exactly. Good point, Lisa. I hadn't put it in those words, but that's exactly right.
Nicole, it's so great to have you back
here. Welcome back.
Yeah, I love it. All right, stay with us. We'll be right back, and we're going to barbecue boot camp when we do.